Hello,
what's
everybody.
Up, yo, it's Tyrone. I'm the more important one here. Also, my sidekick's here.
Hello, everybody. This is Aaron, and tonight we are going to be playing Half-Life Blue Shift. So we're going to roll over here to the new game. Let's put it on medium, because I'm not very manly.
Wait, you don't want to play the mandatory training level that was in every one of the games during this era?
Yeah, this is going to go well.
I completely forgot about this being at the beginning of the game.
So while we're waiting, a bit of introduction. Half-Life, revolutionary game, very well celebrated game. Most of you hopefully already know about it. You play as a heroic mime named Gordon Freeman. And they created an expansion pack to it called Opposing Force, where you played as a really cool soldier named...
What was his name?
Adrian Shepard.
We're playing as neither of those guys.
Yeah, you probably get paid, like... I mean, better than minimum wage, because this is, like, a really bitchin' facility, but... You probably aren't getting paid that well. Oh, man. That's a cool pizza quirk. Oh, no, it's Tony Pizza! Oh, Tony's still in business, buddy!
I'm more worried about the fact that there were no safety rails there.
Undecided major.
So despite being far less qualified than Gordon Freeman, we will actually be doing about the same amount of stuff he does, or at least the same tasks today.
We don't even have a liberal arts degree. Let's face it.
See, he's a security guard, and the name of the episode is Insecurity.
Haven't heard that one before.
Alright, let me get used to this thing where I don't have any good hand. Hopefully this guy lets us in, because I'm already lost.
Who is that guy?
3 minutes into the game, onto a... Oh, was that some G-Man glitch stuff? No, he's just glitching. Hi, Gordon Freeman! Good choice for a game to play through, by the way. So far, nothing but action.
Look, a door. Hey, flashlight works.
I'm here.
It's funny how this is an expansion pack, because that means you can tell, because there's like higher res parts of his character model against the lower res background.
I guess we can't go on duty without our sidearm and uniform. So this is actually really cool that we have this amount of sort of interaction in the game. Before we started, we get this big amount of sort of world building. This isn't done as much anymore. With the advent of better graphics and such, we probably need it less, but, you know, it's still neat.
I don't know. I mean, there are some games that do this, but they do it very minimally, and they just do it for, like, one scene. And they're like, okay, we got that out of the way.
I don't have my sidearm.
No, you don't. Guns are in the bathroom, silly. Armory. Sidearm. Coincidence?
I really feel like I'm a lot shorter than Zellier than I ought to be.
Listen to those footsteps.
That is a man who is terrified of losing his job.
Oh, a gun magazine. You see, that's not a real gun magazine they had in the 1990s, because it's in color.
Because this is an old game where that is a thing you need to do.
I'm a security officer. This is,
I'm confiscating.
Necessary.
This isn't safe. There we go.
Security.
Alright, everything's safe now.
I think you have a different version of Black Mesa than I do. Because you're not holding a Glock, and...
This isn't Black Mesa.
Oh! Black Mesa.
Oops.
Whoops. Wrong game.
Just accidentally discharged my firearm in the office, because I forgot that alternate fire happens in this game.
What, you didn't remember that the pistol has a really fast shooty mode? The other one?
I have too many bullets! I'm gonna do a lot of strafing, because,
wait, go back. No, put your gun at that scientist again.
It's just,
Well, look at the
Oh, it's auto aim. Cool. Good, that'll help with the fact that I'm terrible at video games. I like that it auto aims at friendly targets, too.
So that's why they hired somebody who didn't have a decided major.
Am I supposed to be down here?
I don't think so, but there was an explosion noise. I know that a bunch of guys you passed earlier, something explodes on them, so...
So, for the record, there's gonna be at least one section that I have to cut out of this video, because we will get lost. I already know that there's a place that I get entirely lost in this game, and I wander around for a couple hours. This wasn't opening. Oh, now it's opening. Making me look dumb, game. Thanks. Sure. High voltage. What's physics?
It's like state-of-the-art physics.
Let's go into this.
It feels really awkward to make fun of this game because, you know, it was old and incredibly revolutionary at the time. I mean, maybe not so much Blue Shift because it was an expansion pack and bigger and better things were already out.
See, he makes sense. It's okay for him to be glitching. That's sort of normal. That's actually the most normal he gets. Look at the texturing on his pants.
And his shoes. I'm so glad you scientists couldn't figure this out.
Once again, glitching.
I think you have a different version that they tried to update and obviously did not
I kind of like
fix some things.
It gives it a very...
It wouldn't have been out of place in the original release, though.
It also gives it a very indie feel. Did you ever manage to interpret anything that this spooky voice was saying?
No, it was incredibly bad.
Do you think it would make them feel better if I discharged my firearm?
I was about to say when you jumped in the elevator, alright, security, we're here with shooty guns.
He's probably fine. It's probably good.
Don't worry, we'll... tick him off the property. What's a resonance cascade?
So this is a game called Half-Life, and in the original Half-Life, there was a very big event called a resonance cascade that the main character caused, which invited alien visitors and threw an entire complex into a state of chaos.
Are you sure you're not thinking of a proton collapse?
No, I'm not. It will be up to us to take a crowbar.
Oh man, that is a big crowbar.
But I got my pistol first. Why would I ever use that? Hi. So...
Look at your terrible ability to deal with recoil.
Where'd it go? Well, that's ominous.
None of the things that you are doing are bright.
Oh, hi.
Behind us.
I didn't see that coming at all. Well, time to destroy company property.
Oh.
Oops. That,
Party's over, people, ladies and gents.
That
sorry.
Did not help my own situation very much.
Wait,
didn't it? I'm the best.
This is like that level in Halo where if you deactivate the security before you're told to, Cortana's like, good, they won't lock us out now.
Alright.
I don't think it was good to walk over that witness.
No, I think that is some sort of toxic waste. And that is a head crab.
I like it that sometimes it's not entirely clear in this game if there's toxic waste or something like that.
It is entirely clear that I'm being attacked by a lot of head crabs.
Like
ladies and gentlemen, gameplay. Come in! Come in!
What can we help you with?
Nothing, I was just about to say.
Hi, Mom.
Sorry.
It's okay.
For everyone watching, our mother has joined us. Say hi, Mom.
Hi, Mom.
I'm not sure if that picked up. All right. We'll probably split this out anyway.